Good evening, everyone. Veteran journalist Ralph Renick, who spent more than 35 years delivering the news to South Florida right from this very studio, passed away last night.
Renick had been hospitalized for most of the last few months with complications stemming from hepatitis and liver failure. He was 62 years old. Ralph Renick wasn't just a television news anchorman. When he started here at WTVJ 42 years ago as a staff announcer, he was making $40 a week. And who would have dreamed he'd go on to make history as the longest reigning local anchorman ever on television?
WTVJ Miami, South Florida's largest daily circulation. The Ralph Renick Report.
He was, for the better part of four decades, the man South Florida turned to for news.
Now here's Ralph Renick.
Good evening, everybody.
Ralph Renick, serious, conservative, upstanding, no nonsense. Renick was South Florida, but even more than that, Ralph Renick was
District
Channel 4.
District 113 Republican election.
The Miami-bound FEC passenger train, the Gulfstream, is derailed at West Palm Beach this afternoon.
He was just a kid, really, when he joined Florida's only television station back in 1949. But by July of 1950, the skinny kid was on the air, anchoring a nightly newscast before anyone knew what a TV anchor was supposed to be.
Time left to say goodnight, and may the good news be yours.
There were no rules to follow, so Renick made the rules, and he set the standards, standards we still respect.
He was definitely an institution. He was a beacon. He was the target for everyone. I think if you had a look at today's television market in Miami, that you would have to attribute the excellence of this market to Ralph Renick.
I think that's absolutely true. Ralph was everybody's idol and ideal, and those of us who came into the business a few years behind him tried very hard to strive for the qualities that he had already established.
In the beginning, there was no network, no tape, no graphics. Film of national events often got here so late, Renick had to improvise.
The pictures we had, we clipped out of newspapers and magazines and stuff like that, and we had nothing. I mean, he used to go out and shoot film.
Ralph wasn't afraid to do things different, and he wasn't afraid to try things.
No, he wasn't. Being number one just wasn't enough. In 1957, Renick instituted the country's first daily television editorials.
As I stated at the outset of this nightly editorial on September 2nd, no endorsement would be given any candidate for political office.
Off the air, Ralph Renick was a tough taskmaster, demanding much from those around him. But he drove himself too, especially in the early years, becoming the first local anchor to leave the anchor desk and travel the world to gather news.
Do you think it would be possible for you to soon visit Miami, Dr. Castro?
Well, I'm very happy for that invitation.
In 1959, he spent 3 weeks in the Soviet Union, snaring Nikita Khrushchev for an exclusive interview.
And now, Ralph Renick reports the news.
And talk about chances. Orson Welles had nothing on Ralph. In this 1960 program, Renick simulated what his newscast might be like if South Florida were taken over by communists.
People's Army militiamen stood majestically on the steps of the Dade County Courthouse, where the new regime will make its headquarters. Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you the truth. We've been taken over by a totalitarian...
At 6 feet four, Ralph Renick was an imposing physical being. His mere presence could be intimidating.
He was very impressive, and he was scary. You know, you talk to Ralph, and you say, "Hi, Ralph." You go, how are you? You know, you kind of shake all over.
He could be very aloof.
Could be, would be. But get Ralph Renick out of the station, and he was the funniest, friendliest, wittiest guy in the world, a guy who could laugh at himself.
Over the course of his career, Ralph interviewed seven United States presidents. It was never totally clear who was granting whom an audience.
The man who rarely smiled on the air smiled a lot in the community, and he was everywhere, an active leader in the Boy Scouts of America, with the Catholic Church, heading a committee to restore the Statue of Liberty, another committee to honor the Challenger astronauts, reading to the blind on radio. Ralph Renick was in demand as a public speaker, as a master of ceremonies, as a teacher.
Here we go, the story's beginning, you better hurry up. Okay, can you sit over here?
But he was also in demand as a father, having raised six children after the death of his wife, Bain, in 1964. His kids, and later their kids, appeared on the air with Ralph every year at Christmas time.
The votes were invalidated because two punches had been made on the voting card.
As a TV news anchor, Ralph Renick was number one in the ratings for almost all of his 35-plus years on the air. That didn't hurt his job security one bit, but neither did the fact that Channel 4's owner, Wometco president Mitchell Wolfson, thought of Renick as his son and gave him virtual free rein in building the Channel 4 news department. Renick's success was also due in no small part to this woman, for 30 years Renick's right hand. If Ralph Renick built the news department, Ruth Sperling ran it. For Renick, Camelot began to crumble in 1983 with the death of Mitchell Wolfson. When Wometco and Channel 4 were sold to an investment firm in 1984, the handwriting was on the wall. Renick, whose brothers Bob and Richard have always been active politically, had for years harbored political ambition himself. He finally took the plunge.
It is my decision, effective tonight, to step down as vice president and news director of WTVJ and also relinquish my duties as newscaster editorialist on this program.
Renick would begin an unsuccessful six-month run for the Democratic gubernatorial nomination, but not before an emotional farewell.
I thank you for being the most supportive TV news audience anyone could ever hope to have.
And then it was time to say goodbye.
Weaver, you're the only one left here. What's happening?
I'm going to miss you.
Yeah.
I really am.
You have nobody to bounce your jokes off of. Yeah,
not going to be the same anymore.
And it wasn't, of course. Renick returned to television in 1988 to do editorials for Channel 6. But by September of 1990, he'd had enough.
Well, J.D., this is not the farewell. It's more goodbye for now.
But for Renick, it was farewell. And for South Florida, it was the end of an era.
Good night, and may the good news be yours and hopefully mine.
Ralph, we're going to miss you.
But those of us who grew up with Ralph Renick will remember him for more than just his nightly newscasts. He gave so much to this community over the course of his life, helping to make South Florida a better place for all of us.
When we come back, we're going to talk to some of Renick's friends and community leaders about his contributions from behind and away from the anchor desk.
Remembering Ralph Renick, he was our eyes and our voice for more than three decades. And as you listen to this excerpt from a typical 1951 newscast, you'll realize how much Ralph grew right along with South Florida.
Good evening, everyone. Tuesday, October 6th, and here are tonight's Florida and local news briefs. The Miami-bound FEC passenger train, the Gulfstream, is derailed at West Palm Beach this afternoon. But reports say only two persons have suffered minor injuries. The remaining passengers are continuing on to this city by bus. Dade County today orders dams removed from four canals as dairymen are up in arms over their flooded pasture lands. The State Road Board rules today on South Florida Road 9. Its inclusion into the proposed turnpike, and a county worker is killed by an automobile.
Ralph Renick died last night. He was 62 years old, but what he gave to all of us in South Florida will be remembered for a long time to come. It's what Ralph did away from the anchor desk that helped this community grow and prosper. Channel 4's Ed O'Dell tells us that's how many South Floridians are remembering Ralph tonight.
The news of Ralph Renick's demise hit the community where he made his biggest impact, in the heart.
He had a great ability to make people feel good about themselves, good about the community.
He was a tremendous influence on two generations of Floridians. He helped shape our understanding of what television news was. He helped us develop a sense of community.
I've been involved in Kiwanis and Rotary and a bunch of organizations, and I've seen him out on many of those functions. So.
It's ironic. I grew up listening to the master storyteller delivering the news. I learned my craft in his shadow, and now I find myself at a loss for words to talk about him. Suffice to say, he came into our homes across the television screen as our friend, Ralph Renick.
Anything for the community benefit, he was there. He was always, say, Johnny on the spot. If Ralph Renick was Johnny on the spot, I'd say that would be, that's how I'd classify him. And I'm sure the Lord's going to take care of him.
And in that vein, Ralph Renick, may the good news be yours. In Miami, Ed O'Dell, Channel 4 News.
Ralph Renick was one of a kind, a South Florida pioneer of sorts, part of an era that saw Miami grow from a sleepy small town to a booming metropolis of international importance. Longtime Miami Mayor Maurice Ferre was the politician credited with much of Miami's new image, and the two men were close business associates, working on many community projects together. Mr. Ferre, what will you miss the most about Ralph?
Well, you know, I can't think of Miami without Ralph. I came here in 1952, so I've been here for almost 40 years, and Ralph was always a part of Miami, part of the news, but he was also part of many of the activities that were going on in Miami. In a way, Ralph really was Miami. He was the symbol of Miami in many, many ways.
You called on him for many community projects.
Yes, I did. Because Ralph represented Miami so well, and he was such a glib person. He was such a kind individual as a person. He had such a great sense of humor. He represented Miami with a great deal of dignity. He went with us on trips. We went to France when Nice became a sister city. Ralph was always there.
He was there out in the community. He got out from behind the anchor desk.
Absolutely.
That was as important to him as delivering the news.
And when something important came up, you know, it was just a natural thing to call Ralph Renick and Mitch Wolfson, I must say. Those are the times when Mitch Wolfson and Ralph Renick really were, in a way, part of the same team.
You had a great opportunity to see his humor, particularly on the luncheon circuits that the two of you traveled in, giving speeches. Do you find that it was odd that he did not show that humor on the air at all? They were very distinct personalities.
Well, Ralph, I think, was a real professional. And I think he took his professionalism very seriously. I think what he was professionally, what he did for a living, he did well, and he knew he did well. He was the master of it. When he got off of the set, I think he was a totally different man. He was a man full of the same charm, but a great deal of wit. I mean, he was really a funny guy. I got to say that in the 40 years that I've been here, the two funniest public figures that I remember were Chuck Hall and
Ralph. Renick. Maurice Ferre, thanks for being with us this evening. Bob?
To the people who worked for Ralph Renick, the man was a giant, going down in the history books as one of broadcasting's finest. Jim Brosmer, a former colleague of mine, worked for Ralph for 15 years here at Channel 4. He joins us now live from Palm Beach. Jim, thank you so much for being with us tonight. And how do you best remember Ralph?
Well, Bob and Susan, I think Ralph probably will be best remembered for his ability to work very hard during the transition from what newspapers told us journalism was into what television, what the capability of television was in telling people what was going on around them. Up until Ralph in 1949 and the early 50s, up until the time that he started doing these broadcasts, we were pretty much newspaper. We wrote it straight. We didn't have a great deal of graphics. We didn't have all the fancy satellite stuff that we have now. And Ralph was able to see the potential of television as a news medium, and he was able to take what the newspapers had told us over centuries of journalism and apply that to television. And I think that's probably what I remember most about Ralph Renick.
You grew up in South Florida, Jim, as did I. How much of a beacon to this business was Ralph to you?
Well, Bob, you and I go back about 25 years in the business, and we knew each other in the late 60s. And I was working at the time as a reporter at Channel 10, and I can remember that Ralph was the one who was we always tried to unseat. He was the one to beat. He was the man to go after. He was the one who set the example.
All right, Jim Brosmer, thank you very much for joining us tonight from Palm Beach.
My pleasure, Bob.
Jim, of course, knew Ruth Sperling, and if ever a man had a right hand to count on, Sperling was it for Ralph. When she joined him here in 1953, there were just 5 people in the news department.
Ruth joined Ralph in 1953 as his secretary, but ended as assistant news director, friend, confidant, protector. It was a partnership with a bond of steel.
He has the best sense of humor of anyone I've ever met in my life. He just couldn't portray that on the air. He was very serious. The minute the camera went off, he was like another person.
Sperling says Renick had a wonderful life, both off and on the air.
When he left, he still was number one, and he felt good that he got out when he did.
Coming up on this Channel 4 News special, remembering Ralph Renick for teaching us to hold our leaders and policymakers accountable for their actions. Some of his most memorable editorials and reports when we come back.
Good evening, everybody. This is Ralph Renick reporting. There are happy faces in this crowd outside Hangar S at the Air Force Missile Test Center at Cape Canaveral. There are smiles on the faces of President Kennedy, Vice President Johnson, and on the faces of John Glenn and his family also. Smiles across the nation on the faces of American citizens today. At the moment, the president is paying honor to the astronaut on behalf of the American people.
In case you've just joined us tonight, we are looking back at the life of former Channel 4 newsman Ralph Renick, who died last night of liver failure.
Renick made television history from this very studio back in 1957 when he delivered the first of what would be thousands of daily television editorials. Until that time, the editorial page was reserved for newspapers, and no one had ever dared to think it had a place on television. No one except Ralph Renick.
As I stated at the outset of this nightly editorial on September...
When Ralph Renick began his nightly editorials on September 2, 1957, everything was fair game. From Latin America...
Our course of action now should be to help the other countries of Latin America find a better life. This will ensure our own peace and security. If we fail to do these things, we will be guilty of selling our neighbors down the river to communist slavery.
To local politics, which was a Renick favorite.
City Commissioner Joe Carollo is using the current proceeding as a witch-hunting device. If Mr. Carollo has evidence of corruption in city government, there are places to take that evidence and procedures to get at the truth.
Now political leaders had to pay attention, had to do things for the people, because if they didn't, Ralph was there with an editorial saying, hey, you're not doing this for the people.
Many of Renick's editorials stood the test of time.
Why couldn't it happen in Miami just like it happened in Chicago? We're talking about having a Major League Baseball team.
And he often went out on a limb. Take this editorial, which aired during the late 50s, about a 16-year-old black male teenager who broke into the home of a prominent white woman and stole $25. When the teen was sentenced to life in prison, Renick hit the air, outraged.
The stiff sentence smacks of the dark ages of the South. It is the type of frontier justice that in recent years has fortunately faded away. You can be sure that today's sentence will receive undue attention. This is the type of recognizance which most citizens of Florida deplore.
Whether Renick's editorials were liked or disliked never mattered. Renick was controversial. He went for the jugular when the situation called for it. And those editorials gave him tremendous clout in South Florida. Bob?
Still to come on this Channel 4 News special, some of Ralph Renick's finest television moments, a few that actually made him blush. But most of Renick's scoops just made him number one for nearly 40 years.
Dr. King, what do you think the FBI should be doing that it's not doing?
Well, I think the greatest need at the present time is to give the Negro and his allies in this struggle a new sense of hope and a new sense of faith. Faith in the judicial process. And I think the FBI could help in this instance by making arrests in cases where civil rights are denied.
We've talked at length about Ralph Renick's importance in this community. He mingled with the movers and shakers of South Florida because he was so involved. Renick was often tipped off to exclusive stories in the making. There are so many scoops, we couldn't begin to list them all. But the one his viewers are most likely to remember is the night Renick was scooped, the night a scoop broke on the air without Renick's consent.
Top concern of Americans today is...
Excuse me, Ralph.
The cost of living.
No, I don't want to interrupt your editorial. I've never done this before, but there is somebody very special here that we would like you to meet, and here he is, Mayor Clark.
Hello, Mayor.
Hi, Ralph. How are you?
Sit down. Very good.
You take this seat, don't you?
It was the celebration of Renick's 30th year on the air at Channel 4. And in honor of that, Metro Dade Mayor Steve Clark proclaimed it Ralph Renick Day.
As we say with heartfelt thanks, may the good news always be yours, Ralph Renick. This is yours, Ralph.
Thank you, Mayor. Have a seat, please. Have a seat here.
Ralph, we have something here for you. We're going to bring it in. We'd like to show it to you since this is your day here. And here it is, a beautiful cake and a floral arrangement with a big four that's just beautiful. And all the people who work with you. And here they are. If we can fit them all in, we can't get everybody in, but let's say that most of the people work with you are trying to get in here just to wish you the very best on this occasion. And I think at this time it's nice to give Ralph just a big hand, 30 years of great service.
Well, we start 31 years tomorrow.
That's right.
So we hope the future years will be as good as the past. And thank you again, Steve Clark. And I'll say, as I've said for almost 30 years, good night. And, well, the good news is really mine. Thank you.
It was that night, and for the 35-plus years Ralph Renick was on the air, the good news was actually ours, because we had Ralph. And through him, we watched South Florida grow up. We trusted Ralph. He was our link to the world.
Ralph steered us through the good times and the bad times with a sense of calm and reason. He was not only our bridge to history, he made history. Ralph Renick leaves behind a standard of excellence in broadcast journalism and a deep sense of community spirit. To Ralph, we say goodbye. To all of you, good night.
Good night.
This is our last dance together. Tonight soon will be long ago. And in our moment of parting, this is all I want you to know.
Good night, and may the good news be yours. And hopefully mine.
Yes, I may dream a million dreams, but how can they come true if there will never, ever be another?
Hi, I'm Shelly. Thank you for checking out our NBC6 South Florida YouTube channel. You want more videos like the kind you just watched? Click right here on the subscribe button below. Get the latest stories, interviews, caught on camera, and more. Digital exclusives as well. All for you. Subscribe now.